Starting out to talk more about the Aquino administration, its expectations and plans, is the spokesperson for the Presidential Communications Group, Ricky Carandang. Good morning, Ricky. Thanks
for being
with us.
Good morning, Mikey.
Secretary Ricky.
Yes, Mikey. How have you been?
Good. Okay. Now the market is up by about 15% year to date. We see a lot of foreign buying. To what do you attribute all this bullishness? The recent bullishness.
Well, there's two things. First of all, we're all aware that there are certain problems going on in Europe and America that have made their economies a lot less optimistic. So people are looking for stability, and they're finding it here in Asia, and particularly here in the Philippines. Take a look, for example, you're mentioning that the index at up 15%. It hit 5,000 yesterday. It's staying above 5,000 so far. Of course, markets go up and they go down. But the fact is that 2 years ago, who would have thought that we would be able to sustain the index above 4,000? And here we are breaking 5,000. Take a look, for example, also at our debts. Since when could you have imagined that the Philippines could borrow money in the international bond market for less than Spain? And more or less about the same as, say, Italy. So they're looking at us in a very different way. That's partly because the European economies aren't doing too well. Also because, in contrast to that, we're doing well. We have debt levels that are very manageable. You've got private sector investments that's coming in. We're doing, 37-40% growth in private sector investments last year. This is direct investments, not just portfolio. So there's a lot of good news coming out of the region and the Philippines in particular. And that's why you're seeing, I think, the index hitting 5,000.
Monetary policy is also, they've been also very loose with that.
That's right. Take a look at this. The central bank this week, was it last week? Last week, the central bank lowered interest rates. What does that signal? That they're not so concerned about inflation, that they are concerned about growth, and they're concerned about encouraging growth. So even the central bank is saying there's room to grow, and there's not a lot of worry about inflation, despite what we're seeing in world oil markets.
Right, it's been largely in line with expectations. Speaking of the growth that you mentioned, last year growth came in at a scant 3.7%. This year, the IMF expects growth to come in at 4.2%. Is this in line with your own expectations? I know you're expecting a 5-6% growth. More optimistic than the IMF.
That's right. I mean, if you take a look at the IMF projections, they do tend to be a little bit more conservative than the government projections historically. So if they're looking at 4.2, we're looking at about 5-6%. That's pretty much in line with what the market expects this year.
Where will this growth come on the back of?
Well, the growth will come from, first of all, domestic demand. We're doing a lot of spending on social services. We're ramping up our CCT, conditional cash transfer. Importantly, for the people watching us now, we've ramped up spending on infrastructure. As you know, we were trying to put new procedures for spending in place and procurement. That led to a bit of a slowdown in spending in the first half of last year. But we were doing that so that we could make sure that there was very little leakage from government's budget. And last year, we saved at one point as much as 42 billion pesos because we were spending money right. And because we took the time to change the processes, we were now able, let's say, in the last quarter of last year and moving into this year, to spend more money on infrastructure. If you take a look at our deficit figure for December, that was a record high because in that 1 month alone, we managed to release a lot of money. So we're going to continue with aggressive infrastructure spending. That's going to help offset, to some extent, what we might see as slower exports this year. The uncertainty over remittances.
Mm-hmm. In terms of the PPPs in particular, since you mentioned spending on infrastructure, why has the bidding taken so long? Well, so far, it's just the Daanghari project that's come underway.
Yeah, Daanghari was bidded out. The Ayala's got that this year. Well, it's very similar to what we did with our spending. You know, in the past, you would come in and you'd invite investors to come in and you would take shortcuts on the rules, give them certain things. It wasn't done in transparency. What would happen is there would be a review. And there would be questions about whether the process was followed. So you did something quickly, but you didn't follow the right process. You jeopardized the entire deal. What we've decided to do is let's take our time. Let's make sure that all the I's are dotted, all the T's are crossed, all the laws and regulations are followed. And as a result of that, we can come in and we can sign a deal and we can be fairly confident that it's not going to be questioned or reviewed or undone by future administrations. So
that's well and good, but how do you fast track this? Because, you know, growth gets affected.
That's
3.7% last year. I mean, you know, taking your time and making sure you dot all the T's, cross out all the cross out all the T's, dot all the I's.
Yeah.
How do you make sure that growth is, you set the foundations for faster growth also?
Well, you do that by doing the process correctly. And when we've done it with Dong Hari, we're going to do it with a few more this year. And I think people will see that once they get used to the new way of doing things, then they will be able to come in and we will set the foundations for growth. But the foundations for growth are going to be set for a long term, not sort of thing, not for a short term. It would be easy to approve 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 projects and just not go through the procedure. But you can be sure that someone out there is going to question those deals if we do it that way. We think we're better off over the long run, taking our time, making sure the processes are followed, making sure that you sign a contract that it's bulletproof, that you can't, it'll stand up to legal and political scrutiny, and nobody will say down the line, hey, you can't do this. And if it's taken a little bit more time, I think investors will realize that that's better off. We're better off doing that and then trying to rush something that isn't ready.
Out of the PPP projects slated, which ones are the Aquino administration most excited about?
Well, I won't get into specifics because there's a lot of stuff and I don't want to preempt any announcements by the economic team. But we are, and I think the public knows this, we're making a big thrust toward tourism. It's more fun in the Philippines, and we really believe that, by the way. But you know,
don't we all?
Yeah, okay. And yeah, it really is. But anyway, what do we need to do to support the tourism campaign? We need to, for example, to build up our airports, expand our airports. And we're seeing the major airports being expanded there in terms of their capacity. The roads and bridges leading to destinations like Palawan and things like that, they're all being built up so that when the tourists actually come here, then they won't have a problem with the airport, they won't have a problem with the roads and bridges getting to their destinations. And so the infrastructure spending project, the PPPs, are all sort of in line with that thrust of ours.
Okay, now onto another hot topic, mining. Many people say that the EO is going to be make or break for the industry. This EO was supposed to be released last February, but due to some revisions, it's been delayed. When can we expect this to come out, and what's it going to be like?
Well, I don't want to tie us down to a specific date. The cabinet is reviewing it. It began, let me walk you a little bit through the process. It began with what I call the environmental cluster, the DENR, the Climate Change Commission. They got the first pass at that. And now it's being looked at by the economic cluster. And so it's going through a very deliberate process where different concerned agencies are able to look at it and provide inputs. And then we're going to go and consult with the stakeholders, the business community, the environmentalists. All of them will be consulted as we craft a mining policy. The problem with mining is this country has gone from almost completely allowing it totally to completely banning it, and then completely allowing it again.
And so gotta meet halfway.
Yeah, no, if you look at mining over the last, say, 30 or 40 years, it has oscillated from one extreme to the other. And I think that's why investors have had a hard time coming in, because they don't know what's going to happen. And what we want to do with this executive order is really to say, this is what this administration's position is on mining, and it will be this position consistently. And then you won't get the oscillating from extreme positions that we had in the last several decades. Mm-hmm. What do we want to do? If you listen to Cesar Purisima, again, I don't want to preempt.
Well, can you answer this?
Yeah.
After this EO, can we expect mining to contribute to a bigger portion of GDP?
That is absolutely what we're hoping for. I mean, what's the mining industry looking for? What are the environmentalists looking for? They're looking for a clear set of rules that incentivize responsible mining, but at the same time, don't allow these activities to overly harm the environment. And we're trying to find the balance. You've seen the debates. It's been widely covered by media. You know how passionate people are about the issues of mining on both sides. And that's a pretty difficult constituency to manage. What we want to do is we want to come up with a policy that will entice investments, but will not scare the environmentalists. I mean, there's going to be extremists on both sides that you'll never please. But I think there's a broad center that if we do this right, we'll come in and we'll look at this mining policy of this administration and say, this is an environment where we can invest in.
And when can we expect this EO to come out?
We're looking in, well, again, I said, I don't want to pin myself down to a specific date, but we realize how important this is, and we're working on it. It's going through the process, and we hope to come out with it fairly soon.
All right, well, thank you for sharing the views of the administration with us, Secretary Ricky Carandao.
Thank you, Mike.
And at the foreign exchange market, as of 10:25 this morning, the peso has reached a weighted average of 42.881. This is on volume worth $399 million. Paolo, over to you.
All right, Mikey before Paolo.
Or Pinky.
I want to ask a few questions
okay.
to Secretary Carandang. Does
Pinky
he have an override?
Has a question for you. No, he doesn't, but
can you pass
tell
it?
Me the question and I'll relay it.
You can pass it over, Mikey. It might
okay,
be a couple
I'll pass
of questions
the override
if that's
over.
Possible. Thanks a lot, Mikey. All right.
You know, I used to work with her, so.
Hey, I remember you. Hey, Secretary Carandang, just a few questions. Number one, Mikey already asked about the take of government on the draft mining policy of the government. We spoke to Leo Seren of the Mines and Geosciences Bureau, and he said that so far it's been acceptable because both sides are quite unhappy with the draft on mining.
Well, we don't want both sides unhappy. As I was telling Mikey, we want there's extremists on both sides, but we want the broad center to agree and to support the policy that we eventually come up with.
Okay. The second one, Secretary Carandang, Senator Antonio Trillanes had already said yesterday that there are reports of coup rumors, soldiers being recruited to rise up against the government. What is the government's reaction on this?
I think Senator Trillanes had clarified that while he did get reports of attempts to do that, that apparently no one was biting. And so I don't think he was overly concerned with that. He was, I think, simply just saying that there had been some overtures that they were rejected.
But was government aware that there have been attempts to recruit some soldiers to join a possible coup?
Well, there's always some attempt to paint the government in a negative light. I mean, that's part of democracy. Has it risen to the point where it has to be taken seriously as a destabilizing threat? I don't think so.
Okay, and the last question, Secretary Carandang, government's position on the increase in sin taxes?
Yeah, we had a meeting about that yesterday. What we want to do is really level the playing field. You have four tiers for tobacco, for example, and you basically are selling the same product, and there's no reason why they should have one tax for one product, another tax for another product. If we're able to harmonize the tiers and bring the index up to date, we would be able to raise significant amounts of money for the government, which we would then in turn spend on social services, particularly in health. Mm-hmm. There are estimates, Pinky, that we could raise as much as 60 billion pesos in the first year. And much of that is going to go into building clinics in the provinces, hiring nurses, and putting up medical facilities in far-flung areas.
It also appears that international makers want to enter the Philippines and do business here, but they are quite apprehensive because of the alleged monopoly in the tobacco industry in the Philippines.
That's right. One of the things that we've heard, though, on the positive side, is that British American Tobacco had come in. They'd pulled out a few years ago. They're now beginning to sell their cigarettes again, and they're saying they're going to watch and see what happens with this indexation. If we can create a more level playing field, they may consider investing more in the country. So I think we'll see what happens when the sin taxes bill gets passed.
All right, so Secretary Carandang, good to see you again.
And good to see you too, Pinky.
We'll see you, Secretary. Thanks a lot. Also to Mikey. Mikey, thanks a lot. Hello.